legendary former UT women's basketball coach Pat Summitt died early Tuesday morning from complications related to early onset dementia, Alzheimer's type. Summitt coached 38 seasons in Knoxville and began in a time when women's basketball was an afterthought. Her Lady Vols racked up 1,098 victories, making her the winningest coach in college basketball, men or women. The no-nonsense leader commanded the respect of her players, which led to an astounding mark of winning 84% of their games. Rivalries got national attention and filled arenas, maybe none bigger than the rivalry with Connecticut. The Huskies head coach Gino Auriemma is a villain in Knoxville, but he's grateful for Summitt's contribution to the game.
The name Pat Summitt and college women's basketball, I don't know, you can say one without the other, and I think very few people have ever lived their lives and had that kind of impact on their profession or their sport, and I certainly think that's going to be the legacy that Pat leaves.
Her storied career was like a book, with pages being filled with the fans as time went by. Big Orange Nation was there when she had her son Tyler, who was present on the bench for every game. Her influence went beyond the players that were under her instruction. A young man with a limit higher than the sky stepped onto campus in 1994 to play quarterback for the football team. Pat was an inspiring voice for the freshman that was destined for stardom. While introducing Summitt for the Arthur Ashe Courage Award in 2012, Peyton Manning let it be known what Pat meant to him.
She's been a mentor and a close friend, someone I can look up to and someone I can talk to. And I know I'm just one of many, many people Pat has guided over the years.
Summitt loved to win, but coaching was more than that to her.
I love what I do, so that's my motivation. My motivation is working with young people and going back to trying to help them be successful. I mean, I don't have to coach another day in my life. I don't have to win another game. I don't have anything that I feel like, hey, I've got to prove this. I got to stay in the game and prove this. I love working with these young women and helping them strive to be the best they can be.
But she did win a lot.
And that's it. The Lady Volunteers, the first team ever to go 39-0, and they have won their third straight national championship, unprecedented in the NCAA.
Cases at the University of Tennessee are filled with trophies from Summitt's tenure. She coached 161 young women that donned the orange, white, and baby blue, and she was able to boast a 100% graduation rate. Her advice has been passed down to fans and casual observers who know that if you are on time, you're late. And if you are in trouble, think left foot, right foot, breathe, and go forward. And she did just that, facing the frightening diagnosis of losing the memories of all the great things she ever accomplished, or all the lives she touched in her career. With a smile on her face, she revealed to the world that this time, she herself was in trouble.
Earlier this year, the doctors at the Mayo Clinic diagnosed me with an early onset dementia, Alzheimer's type, at the age of 59.
She vowed to remain head coach and rely on her assistants more than she ever needed to in her career. She coached a final season, going 28-9, before relinquishing command of the giant she created to her former player and longtime assistant, Holly Warlick. Warlick is just one of 17 former players and assistant coaches to get a head coaching job, thanks to the guidance they received under her tutelage. 45 total former players went on to coach in some capacity. The numbers are sketched into history, which will show that one of college basketball's greatest coaching minds ever came from Henrietta, played in Martin, and coached in Knoxville. 16 regular season SEC championships, 16 SEC tournament championships, 38 postseason tournament appearances, an induction into the FIBA Hall of Fame, the Naismith Coach of the Century, a Presidential Medal of Freedom, an induction into the Women's Basketball Hall of Fame, and an induction into the International Women's Sports Hall of Fame are just a handful of the honors bestowed upon the woman that changed women's basketball forever. Her courage led her straight into battle, left foot, right foot, breathe, and go forward.
I've had years of cramped up city life, trapped like a duck in a pen. All I know is it's a pity life can't be simple again.
She gave her final competitor, a horrible disease, everything she had. Her five-year battle finally came to an end.
You know, I just I get a game plan, go into practice, and as time went on, I thought, I can do this.
Pat Summitt leaves the sidelines of life at age 64.